Good morning once again. This is Christ Without Borders. And as I was saying yesterday, I don't know what you're doing this morning, but whatever you are doing, let praise go first. We saw it several times. Every time the children of God, the Israelites, will go to our God, will let the tambourines go first, followed by the Ark of a Covenant. So let praise go first. It's very important. I've spoken about the power of praise. It's here. You can look at that. How the devil hates it when we praise God and flees. He vacates that position, that place immediately. So use this weapon. For the weapon of our warfare, not carnal, but mighty through Christ, to pulling down of strongholds. May every stronghold in your life be brought down this morning by listening to this song. Yes, so this morning I'm going to ask a simple question. Who holds the administrative privileges to your life? Administrative privileges. What does that mean? Is anything, anyone that holds the right to make changes, the right to, and a lot of the time you see it in, when you are dealing with devices or a computer, the person that holds these privileges is the only one that can make changes onto that machine, is the only one that can enforce certain changes, is the only one that can modify certain changes of a computer machine. It also applies to human beings. So who holds these privileges? Is it your flesh or the spirit? Is it your flesh that controls your these privileges, these admin privileges, or is your spirit? Because the Holy Spirit is not controlled by you. The Holy Spirit takes his instructions from the throne room of God. If the Holy Spirit is the one that holds these privileges, you are sure and you know that every decision you will make will be according to the dictates and direction of heaven, which will what? Which will automatically align you on the path of righteousness. It will align on the path of righteousness. A lot of us have recited and said Psalm 23, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. The Lord is what? Shepherd. But it doesn't mean Jesus will appear physically holding a staff trying to lead you. No. He will use his spirit, because One of the revelations of the name of Jesus, which is Emmanuel, is what? God is with us. He's going to do it through the Holy Spirit. Look, if you believe, if you're a believer, I keep telling you, I've spent a lot of time, I've used a lot of examples to try to explain the importance of the Holy Spirit active and functional in the life of each and everybody who says they believe in his name. And people, it seems people have not grasped, you have not grasped it. In Psalm 93, he said what? He leaded me in the path of righteousness. So what? To live a righteous life, the Holy Spirit has to be leading you. You can't do it from the arm of flesh. You feel. The arm of flesh will fail you. I'm telling you. Now, how do you decide who controls these privileges? It's by what you spend time on. It's by what you spend most of your time on. Do you spend more of your time catering to the things of this world? Or do you spend more of your time spending time in your word, spending time in prayer? Do you spend more of your time, even the content you consume on social media? What is it? You consume that. Do you consume things that is more of this world? Do you, the content you even consume on social media? What is it like? Is it made up of things that are more of this world, or is it made up of things that have eternal value? The administrative privileges of you, who controls it? If it's being controlled by the flesh, you are damn sure that everything that will come from heaven is going to reject it and kick it to the side. We have been told that this, the flesh and the spirit, they are always contending. They always war to see. Everybody wants to have control. The flesh wants to control and then move you into sin. This flesh, this mortal being, this flesh you are in, your spirit is in, the only thing he knows how to do is sin. People don't understand it. You see, when Lucifer went into the Garden of Eden, it was a special mission. It was a tactical mission. What for what? He went in there in the Garden of Eden to what? To disconnect Adam and Eve from that, the power and control of the spirit. So that what? He, Lucifer, the devil, who is king when it comes to the flesh and things that don't have eternal value, he is the champion of them. He's a champion of the flesh. So if you are in the flesh, oh my God, you are under his control. He knows how to move you into sin. But if you hand over these privileges and submit your will, truly come into a relationship with Jesus Christ as a Lord and personal Savior, and let and pray and tell him, God, let your will be done in my life. You surrender yourself, surrender your will for the will of the Holy Spirit, for the will of God to be done in your life. And by what? Making a conscious effort and decision to spend more time on things that have eternal value. Spending more time in the Word of God, spending more time in prayer, following and implementing what the Word of God has told you. The Holy Spirit takes charge, and he will implement everything heaven has set for you.